This is Sebastian Middle Martinez for MMA Newt. I'm here with Sahil Siraj, who faces Arbi Mezidov at Fight Club Rush 9 on September 4th. So, Sahil, we've been sitting here talking a little bit, and this is a very big fight coming up. You said previously that you learned a lot from sort of your last fight because you had to make some adjustments. Was your last fight, which you had last summer with Gregorio David La Torre, was that the toughest fight you've had in MMA so far?
I can't call it the toughest fight if it was not because of injury in my hand. It was going to be finished maybe in the first or second round, but I hold myself back because I didn't want to injure more my right hand. It was already cracked, and I go with the plan that win by decision, and I just follow my game plan, the way coach said to me. We win the fight, yes.
But wasn't it because you injured your hand? Did that not make it a tougher fight? Or would you say, because, I mean, most of your fights end in the first round, so I've got to think that this three-round fight had to be the toughest one. Or?
But the thing is, I actually enjoyed the fight, going three rounds, because I never go three rounds. And that's what made it interesting for me, and I enjoyed it. It was not like the toughest fight, it was like the fun fight for me.
So, in other ways, like you being able to get some more cage time was almost better. You got to, you know, show some more weapons, perhaps.
Yes, yes, but there was no time for showing because time goes so fast when you are in the ring. But it was a great fight. Gregory is also a great fighter. He put everything there and I put everything there. And the result, of course, there is one winner and one lose. It's like you say, one learn and one win. It's normal. Yeah.
And so you say, you know, fight goes too quickly. That was still 15 minutes of intense fighting. Sounds to me a little bit like you would really want a five-round main event, right? If you could?
Yes, if it was not because of my hand, I would rather to go five round and try to do something new, you know, because all the time when I go in the fight, it's just like hard hit, knockout, finish. I don't play like normally I do in the gym, my training partners and stuff. And it's good to go three round or five round to get more experience, to be in the cage a little bit, to experience new thing, and not only hit people. You have to experience that you get hit by your opponent also. And because in the future I need all this to be ready for it, not surprised if someone hit me. Ooh, first time experience. Ooh, I'm surprised by it. You know. Yeah. But it's good. It's just sort of my journey, and it's going to be great. It's going to be great.
I don't doubt it for a second. And it's been a little bit over a year now since that fight. Have you been able to sort of try out some new things, maybe train in a different way, or do you mostly continue the way you've been doing before during this whole period?
No, of course. I changed a little bit my game plan because I can't survive without my ground game and without my wrestling. And I can't only just think that, oh, I'm a stand-up guy. I go knock out the guys in the first round. It's finished. It's not going to work. It's not going to work. You can't knock out everyone. Yeah, they also train hard. They also have the same goal you have. They have everything that they wish everything that what you wish for. And that's why my game plan is this time is different. I'm doing my wrestling, my ground game, and yeah, and my stand-up. Yes, of course, I have to try new things and protect myself from my opponent also. It's not just stand-up, because MMA is not a stand-up game. It's mixed martial art. It's a combined jiu-jitsu, wrestling, Thai boxing, kickboxing. You have to be ready in every way that's come to you.
Absolutely. And you've got an opponent now in Arbi Mezidov, who I think will test you in pretty much all avenues. I mean, in my personal opinion, I would say he's probably the most well-rounded fighter you've faced so far. Are you expecting him to take the chance to stand and strike with you, or do you think he's mostly going to go for the takedown?
I watched some of his fights, and I think he's going to stand up with me maybe first round, and if he can keep going, maybe go all the way with stand up. Otherwise, you're gonna, of course, go for takedown, and it's not gonna be easy, the takedown. Yeah, but I'm gonna be ready for everything, no problem.
I don't doubt it. And, you know, that Colgate smile sells it all as well. And on the topic of that, you know, obviously you're here, you're representing both Sweden and Afghanistan heading into this fight. But a little while ago, it was close to not being like that because the migration services were close to sort of sending you out, deporting you from Sweden. Now, luckily, that situation has been resolved and you can still be here in Sweden, which we're all very happy for. But during that period, you know, you had a job here, you had a kid here, and for some insane reason, they decided that you shouldn't be here with your kid, which is absurd. What was that like? I mean, could you sort of just describe, it must have been a roller coaster of emotions, like not being sure where your life was going to be.
Yeah, it was really tough actually in that time. But like I said to you, I never take it like so hard on me. It was one time it was really hard. My wife called immigration in the last time that they tried to send the decision that I have to stay in Sweden or they deport me and stuff. And they said to her that, no, we're going to deport him. You have like 7 days and stuff. You have to go sign the paper and stuff. And she called me. I was with my kids at home. When she said to me like this, it was just, I was all sweat. My body all get wet. And then I said, I stopped for 1 second. I said, what's happening? And then I said, around, no worries, it's going to be okay. I tried to calm her down because she was also crying. It was not easy. Then I just deep breathe. I was putting the clothes in the machine. I just take my daughters. I say, we go change the clothes and the stuff. And on the way, I was just thinking, I say, this is not in my hand anymore. I just leave it, you know, to upper power than me, you know, that what I believe, you know, I say I leave everything to God, you know, like whatever he fixed for me, I accept it, you know. And then I just feel happy back, you know, like I smile and I go down. And then she called me back in 15 minutes. She said to me, it was a mistake. I called another one. She said, no, you get the Opelstam, like the work permit in Sweden. You can stay now. I say, look, some stuff you can't predict what's going to happen, you know. But even like this was the hardest time that, okay, you have to now prepare to leave the country, leave your kids, leave your wife, leave everything you have here, you know. And then the problem was I couldn't come back if I leave the country, you know, because they say that I couldn't, how you say, they didn't accept my identity. This was the problem. Even I leave the country from marriage side, I was not allowed to come back to Sweden. But then they say, no, we did mistake. I say, yes, 7 year mistake. And then because how they find out that it was my identity, they call the Afghan embassy in Sweden. They ask there for everything. And then they say to him, yes, this person is, this is his name. We accept him, blah, blah. I say, 7 years, come on. You can't just reject a person by just one time looking, just say to him, we don't believe what you say and stuff like this. But maybe they have their own problems also. I can't blame because there's much different cases. They can't trust everyone. I understand. But some cases they have to at least check like from their heart. They have to see because it's families, kids. They can't put everyone's life in risk because of one. If they just try to call from the beginning and did something from the start, nothing gonna happen. I was maybe in totally different organ. How you say? Maybe my professional record now up. I can go travel, fight other countries and stuff. I was stuck here almost for 10 years that I couldn't travel. If I had my papers, everything, maybe it gone. It goes good way or maybe bad way, but I'm still happy for what happened until now. I'm happy for my life. Yes.
It's an amazing story, and it sounds, you know, kind of like a Hollywood movie almost. And I say it all the time, but like MMA is the one sport where it's like a movie, both in the fight, in the cage, where, you know, a last minute knockout will happen, but even outside the cage, where you see something like this, where it's like you risked everything, and then it was a small little thing, a small little issue, and then it changed. And yeah, it's just, it kind of encapsulates how unpredictable MMA and life is, right?
Yes, it's true. The MMA is, because this is not only MMA, this is everyone's normal life. And in the MMA, a lot of people can tell their stories. You know, when you become something, or you become a good singer, or movie star, or good fighter, or whatever, you know, then you get the opportunity to tell your story that you come to this place. It was not easy. It was not easy route that you make it to that place. That's why some people think, what is it? Just go train a little bit and then go fight. It's no problem. But it's not like this. There's other stuff in life also. It's not only just training, eating, sleeping, and go fighting and stuff. Win or lose, of course, is fight. Everything is happening in fight. But on the back, there's the truth. There's real other story. You know, how you survive your daily life, you know. It's not only about the fighting and get famous. You have to survive your daily life problems. And actually, everyone have this problem. It's not that only MMA fighters, we have it. It's everyone daily life problems. But you have to fight and survive.
And that you have, and it's been an amazing story. And that story has led you now to the biggest fight in your life in this main event that's coming up on September 4th. How do you see this story playing out September 4th against RB Majidov? What will this story end in?
I can't predict, like I said, you predict nothing, you know, the future. But I'm going to go with full force, and I hope RB is also ready for the great fight, you know, and we can give a great fight to the fans and to the fight fans, you know. But I believe it's going to be a great war, and it's going to be a fight that everyone will talk about it for not long time, maybe a little long time.
You know what? I believe you are completely correct, Sahil. I do believe it will be a great fight. I love the matchmaking for this entire event. So fans at home, be sure to catch Sahil Siraj in the main event against Arbi Mezhidov at Fight Club Rush 9 on September 4th. On UFC Fight Pass or live on the spot at Bombardier Arena. So, Hill, thank you very much for your time, for this double dose of interviews, and good luck in everything leading up to the fights.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Sebastian, for your time, man. I appreciate it. Have a great time.
Likewise, buddy.